Hi, welcome to this tutorial about GuardSim 3D. In this tutorial, we will prepare a car model so it can be used in the traffic simulation. The car model I will be using has a body, four wheels and an armature. The wheels uses rotation and translation constraints to act to the changes in the armature. We don't go over how to create the model itself, as there are many other tutorials from experienced modelers who can do that much better than we can. This tutorial will show how to use such a model and prepare it so you can use it in a traffic simulation. For the wheel animation, we use animation actions. The best way to set up animation actions is to take a number of frames, for example 120 frames, and make animation actions per number of wheel turns. For example, we create an animation action where the wheels make a full turn 360 degrees over their axle in 120 frames. We do the same for two full turns 720 degrees over their axle in 120 frames. And another one for doing three full turns over their axle in 120 frames. We do this so the wheel won't slip when merging the different wheel animations. For each speed, we also create an animation action for turning left and turning right. In the side area of the action editor, there's a GuardSim panel. Inside the panel, you can put the velocity and angular velocity of each animation action. Animation actions can be reused when they have the same rig and wheel sizes. Different wheel sizes will need different animation actions as they have different velocities. Later, when performing the simulation, the actual speed of the agent is matched with the velocity and angular velocity of the animation action to select if that animation action will be merged into the final animation. We are now going to configure the car model. We select the armature of the car and go to the Properties Object tab. Inside this tab, there is a GuardSim 3D panel. We enable this panel. Inside this panel, we can set up material variations. We go back to this subject in a minute. We will start with configuring what meshes are part of this rig. We go to the GuardSim node editor and add a node tree. Give it a name and activate fake user. When not activated, Blender will remove the node tree when it doesn't find any users of the node system. We add an armature node and select the armature of the car. We also add a mesh node and select the body and the wheels objects of the car. When the rig is used during a crowd simulation, the selected mesh objects will also be given to that agent. Let's now set up the material variation for the color of the car. We go back to the GuardSim panel in the Object tab. We press Add Material variable and name the property. We set the type of the variable to color, and we add several colors. Now we need to connect the material variable to the actual material of the car. Car body has a material. A color material variable can only change the RGB nodes. For the body material, we add an RGB node and give it a name. Back at the material variable, we add the material node. We select the material and select the RGB node we just added. The Use as Diffuse option will also update the viewport color of the material when the color variable is changed. For this material, we will enable it. Most likely, you want to use the car in multiple simulations. For that, we create a separate blend file and do all the car configuration there. When we want to use a car model in simulation, we link in this configuration. Here we have a simple simulation blend file with the traffic system. In this simulation, we want to use the car model that we prepared. We link in the configuration of the car model. This can be found in the node groups. And we link in all the animation actions we want to use. We open a CrowdSim node editor and create a new node tree. Inside the node tree, we add the populate node. Inside the populate node, we select the car model that we have linked in. When pressing populate, you see that the car model will be given to all the agents. But all of them still have the same color. We add a material variable node and connect it to the populate node. The node displays the material variables that have been configured for the car model. We add some variances by enabling the variable and set a minimum and maximum value. If we now press the populate, the cars get a random color between the given values. We add the traffic variable node to set the dimensions of the car. And press populate to update the agents. Let's do some traffic simulation. We add the behavior node and the traffic node. We connect them and select the traffic system of the scene. When we press execute behavior, the traffic simulation is baked into the scene. We haven't added the behavior to update the wheel animation yet. In order to do that, we will add a parallel node and a play action node. In the play action node, we select wall and the actions of the car model. And connect them together. After pressing execute behavior, the wheels will be rotating and turning. You can use the blend in, blend out setting in the play action node to reduce the animation glitches. This is the end of this tutorial. We have shown how to prepare car models to be used in the traffic simulation.